A lot of you asked me to make this grunge stamp effect. And here we go, with some free patterns. You can take your graphics to the next level like that. Also, convert the raster result into a vector using a very simple trick. Let's jump into Photoshop and get started. First, let's create a new document. Set width to 3000 pixels, height to 2000, with 8-bit RGB color mode. Then click Create. Grab the Type tool and type any text with any font you like. Create a solid color layer with any color from here. And while holding the Control key, select both layers and right-click them to convert to a Smart Object. Double-click the Smart Object's thumbnail to open it. And once you're inside the Smart Object, delete the color layer as we don't need it anymore. We added it inside the Smart Object to force the Smart Object to have the same dimension as the main document. And if we didn't do that step, the Smart Object will not have any extra space like that. Now press Ctrl and S to update the Smart Object. Close it and get back to your main document, and you'll find that the Smart Object has been updated. Now double-click it to open its layer style. Select the Inner Glow style, with a normal blending mode, 100% opacity, and any color. Also, set the glow source to edge, choke to 100%, and size to 10 pixels. You can make the same step using stroke, but I found this more efficient. Now let's select the pattern overlay, and from this little icon, choose Import Patterns to load the tutorial patterns. You can download them for free from the description below. You will get around 20 patterns with different shapes. Choose any pattern you like and change its scale to an appropriate value from here. Finally, let's hide the color of the layer, which is red in my case. Simply set the layer's fill to 0% and it will be hidden. And if you hide the background layer, you'll see through the pattern like that. Now let's select our layer and go to Filter, Noise, Median. Change it to 3 pixels. And this will get rid of these sharp corners like that. Finally, apply this ripple filter from here. Change its size to large with 20% amount. This will roughen the edges as if there is ink bleeding from them. Now select your layer and press Ctrl and G to add it inside a group. Then add a color fill adjustment layer from here. Drag it outside the group, right-click it, and choose Create a Clipping Mask. And with this color layer, you can control the color of your effect like that. Don't forget to save this project as a PSD file from here for any future use. And let's move on to the next step to see how to use it. Step 2. Update the effect with a click. First, let's double-click on the Smart Object thumbnail to open it. Once you're inside the Smart Object, add the text you want, or just import your design from here. Hide the old layer, then press Ctrl and S to update your Smart Object. Close the Smart Object and get back to your main document. And here is the result. You can double-click the Pattern Overlay effect to pick another pattern. You should select the pattern you want and adjust its scale from here for a better result. I will pick this pattern with around 50% scaling. And here is my result. Before moving to the next step, let's hear from our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of premium classes for all creative and curious people. They have thousands of inspiring classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes about Photoshop only. One class that I really like is the Photoshop Advanced Training Course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And for the first 1,000 people who join Skillshare from the link in my description, we'll get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Now let's get back to our tutorial. Optional step: vectorize the final result. To convert your result to a vector, let's first hide this background layer. Then select the top layer and press Ctrl and Alt and Shift and E on Windows, or Command and Option, Shift and E on Mac to merge visible to a new layer. Point over the thumbnail while holding the Control key, then click on it to make a selection. Open the Paths panel and click on this little icon to convert the selection to a path. And directly, without going anywhere, go and create a solid color layer from here. As you can see, the path combined with a color layer will create this vector layer. And to export it to Illustrator, you'll first need to delete all layers except this vector layer. Then go to File, Save As. If you don't have the EPS file format right here, please go to File, Preferences, File Handling, and check this Enable Legacy Save As. Now let's get back to File, Save As, and the EPS format should appear there. Just select it and click Save. Make sure that your settings are the same as mine while checking Include Vector Data. And you can open it with Illustrator or any vector software. And of course, deal with it as a pure vector like that. Extra tip: apply the effect to a colorful drawing. For a colorful drawing like this, the previous technique will not work. So I made some brushes to make the same effect, and you can import them from here. You can download them for free from the description below under Tutorial Files. Now pick any brush you like. Then change its opacity to around 50%. And with your layer selected, create a layer mask from here. Select the mask, then change the brush color to black and click to paint over your image like that. You can paint with other brushes if you want. And that's it for today. Don't forget to check out this tutorial to learn how to convert your raster images to vector using Photoshop. Thanks for watching.